Hello everyone, let us discuss some important DCET multiple choice questions related to applied science on industrial chemistry. Question number 1. Which of the following is true in case of strong electrolyte? Option A, they ionize completely. Option B, potassium hydroxide is strong electrolyte. Option C, high electrical conductivity. Option D, all of this. A strong electrolyte is a solution that ionizes completely or undergoes dissociation in a solution. These ions are good conductors of electric current in solution. So potassium hydroxide is an example for a strong electrolyte. So the answer D holds good, that is all of this. Question number 2. Electrochemical equivalent is given by Z equal to M by IT, B Z equal to T by MI, C Z equal to I by MT, D IT by M. Electrochemical equivalent Z is the weight of substance that is deposited or evolved during electrolysis by passage of specified quantity of electricity. According to the Faraday's first law of electrolysis, M is directly proportional to Q, where M is the mass, Q is the quantity of current passed. Therefore, M equal to ZQ or Z equal to M by Q, but Q equal to IT, where I is the current in ampere and T is the time in second. So, Z equal to M by IT. Therefore, the option A, Z equal to M by IT, holds good. Question number 3. Disadvantages of composite material are: option A, they are brittle. Option B, difficult to replace and repair. Option C, they have less weight. Option D, both A and B. Here, they have light weight is an advantage, whereas brittle and difficulty to repair is a disadvantage of composite material. So the correct answer is option D, that is both A and B. Question number 4. Mixing of two or more metals at suitable ratio to avoid corrosion is known as: option A, mixing. Option B, alloying. Option C, metallurgy. Option D, manufacturing. So mixing of two or more metals at suitable ratio to avoid corrosion is known as alloying. So the correct answer is option B. Question number 5. Intramolecular forces is strong in A, elastomer, B, fiber, C, thermoplastic, D, thermosetting plastic. Here, the intramolecular forces of attraction is strong in fiber because of hydrogen bonding. Therefore, the option B, fiber, holds good. Question number 6. In which of the following cell reaction is reversible? Option A, solar cells. Option B, primary cell. Option C, secondary cells. Option D, photovoltaic cells or photocells. So in this, the net cell reaction is reversible only in secondary cells, whereas in solar cells, primary cells and photocells, the net cell reaction is irreversible. So the correct answer is option C, secondary cells. Question number 7. Fuel cells require: option A, fuel. Option B, oxidant. Option C, water. Option D, both A and B. So fuel cell is a galvanic cell in which combustion of fuel takes place in presence of oxidant to produce water. So the correct answer is option D, that is both fuel and oxidant. Question number 8. Bronze is a mixture of A, copper and zinc, B, copper and tin, C, iron and carbon, D, tin and lead. The correct answer is option B, copper and tin. Question number 9. pH value of a solution is given by option A, log H plus ion concentration to the base 10, option B, minus log H plus ion concentration to the base 10, option C, minus log OH minus ion concentration to the base 10, option D, minus log H plus ion concentration to the base E. So the correct answer is option B, that is minus log H plus ion concentration to the base 10. Question number 10. Fiber glass is an example for option A, laminate, option B, particulate, option C, short fiber, option D, long fiber. So the correct answer is option C. So fiber glass is an example for short fiber. Question number 11. Which of the following is not a strong electrolyte? A. Sodium chloride. B. Potassium nitrate. C. Ammonium hydroxide. D. Ferrous sulfate. So the correct answer is option C, ammonium hydroxide, because ammonium hydroxide dissociates partially in its solution. Question number 12. pH of blood is option A 6.8, option B 7, option C 7.8, option D 7.3. So the correct answer is option D. The pH of the blood is 7.3. Question number 13. During smelting, an additional substance is added which combines with impurities to form a fusible product. It is known as A. Slag, B. Mud, C. Gangue, D. Flux. The correct answer is flux, because flux is added during smelting which combines with impurities to form a fusible product called slag. Question number 14. Galena is an ore of A. Titanium, B. Lead, C. Silicon, D. Silver. So the correct answer is galena is an ore of lead. Question number 15. Which of the polymer is a copolymer? Option A, polyethylene. Option B, polytetrafluoroethylene. Option C, polyvinyl chloride. Option D, nylon 66. So the correct answer is option D, nylon 66, because nylon 66 is a copolymer which is produced by condensation reaction of two different monomer. Question number 16. A fuel cell is used to convert chemical energy into option A, mechanical energy, option B, solar energy, option C, electrical energy, option D, potential energy. So the correct answer is option C, electrical energy, because a fuel cell is used to convert chemical energy into electrical energy through a pair of redox reactions. Question number 17. The process of deterioration of metal due to unwanted chemical or electrochemical interaction of the metal with its environment is called A. Electrolysis, B. Electrodialysis, C. Corrosion, D. Deposition. So the correct answer is option C, corrosion, because corrosion is nothing but the process of deterioration of metal due to unwanted chemical or electrochemical interaction of the metal with its environment. Question number 18. Which of the following is not a primary cell? Option A, Dechelange cell, option B, dry cell, option C, Western cell, option D, nickel cadmium cell. So the correct answer is option D, because Dechelange cell, Western cell and dry cell, these are nothing but the primary cell. whereas nickel cadmium cell is a secondary cell. So the correct answer is option D, nickel cadmium cell. Question number 19. Composite materials are classified based on A. type of matrix, B. size and shape of reinforcement, C. both, D. none. The correct answer is option C, that is both, because composite material are classified based on type of matrix, size and shape of reinforcement. Question number 20. The polymer which is used in non-sticky kitchenware is A. PVC, B. Teflon, C. rayon, D. isoprene. The correct answer is option B, Teflon, because the polymer Teflon is generally used in non-sticky kitchenware. To form a galvanic cell, A. difference in concentration of electrolyte is required, B. difference in concentration of frequency is required, C. difference in concentration of amplitude is required, D. both B and C. The correct answer is option A, that is difference in concentration of electrolyte is required. Question number 22. pH value is not having its application in A. determination of quality of soil, B. determination of quality of textile dyes, C. determination of quality of chemicals, D. determination of quality of electron. Here the correct answer is option D, that is pH value is not having its application in determination of quality of electron. Question number 23. The prefix mega stands for A. 10^3, B. 10^-3, C. 10^-6, D. 10^6. Here the correct answer is option D, 10^6, because 10^6 mega is a unit prefix in metric systems of unit. Question number 24. In a lead acid battery, the level of electrolyte should be A. equal to that of plates, B. below the level of plates, C. above the level of plates, D. half the level of plates. Here the correct answer is option C, above the level of plates. Question number 25. Plastic is A. good conductor of electricity, B. good conductor of heat, C. bad conductor of electricity, D. semiconductor material. Here the correct answer is option C, plastic is a bad conductor of electricity. Question number 26. The fastest mode of transfer of heat is A. conduction, B. radiation, C. convection, D. transmission. Here the correct answer is B. radiation. Question number 27. At absolute zero temperature, the pressure and volume of a given mass of a gas is A. 1, B. -273, C. 273, D. 0. Here -273 is known as absolute zero. If one could lower the temperature to absolute zero, the pressure of ideal gas would be zero, since gas would exert no force on container. So the correct answer is option B, -273. Question number 28. In cold countries, the windows are provided with double doors because A. air between the two windows behaves as a perfect insulator, B. air between two windows behaves as a perfect conductor, C. to strengthen the windows, D. security purpose. Here the correct answer is option B, that is air between the two windows behaves as a perfect conductor, because here air is trapped and convection current cannot be set easily. So the trapped air reduces the heat loss by conduction or convection. Question number 29. The elasticity of steel compared to rubber is A. more, B equal C less D less than or equal. Here the correct answer is option A, more, because more the value of Young's modulus of elasticity of substance, more is the elasticity. Young's modulus of steel is more than of rubber. Question number 30. Faraday's first law of electrolysis is represented mathematically at A. M equal to ZQ, B. Q equal to MZ, C. Z equal to MQ, D. M equal to Z by Q. Here, the correct answer is option A, M equal to ZQ, because the mass of substance M deposited or liberated at any electrode is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity or charge passed. So the option A holds good. Question number 31. Alloy of steel is a mixture of A. Chromium, iron and nickel, B. Chromium, iron and zinc, C. Chromium, iron and aluminium, D. Chromium, iron and tin. The correct answer is option A, that is, alloy of steel is a mixture of chromium, iron and nickel. Question number 32. The materials with weak intermolecular forces of attraction between polymer chains are A. Elastomer, B. Fiber, C. Thermosetting plastics, D. Thermoplastics. The correct answer is option A, elastomers, because in elastomers, the polymer have elastic properties that can be deformed by applying pressure and intermolecular forces are weakest. Question number 33. If an element emits beta ray, then its atomic number A increases by 1, B decreases by 1, C remains same, D decreases. Here the correct answer is option A, increases by 1, because in beta decay, it is a radioactive decay in which a neutron transforms into a proton or vice versa inside the nucleus of an atom. Since atomic number is the number of protons in the nucleus, an increase in number of proton can cause an increase in atomic number. Question number 34. Which polymers occur naturally? A. Starch and nylon, B. Starch and cellulose, C. Proteins and nylon, D. Protein and PVC. The correct answer is option B, starch and cellulose. Since starch is a natural polymer made by plants and cellulose is made by repeating units of monomer called glucose. Question number 35. In case of liquids, as temperature increases, the viscosity decreases. This is because A. Increase in rate of diffusion of gases, B. Decrease in rate of diffusion of gases, C. Increase in the potential energy of molecules, D. Increase in kinetic energy of molecule. Here, the correct answer is option D, that is, increases in kinetic energy of a molecule, because when the temperature increases, the energy level of liquid molecule increases and distance between the molecule also increases. It causes a decrease in intermolecular attraction between them, which leads to decrease in viscosity. Therefore, the option D, that is, increase in kinetic energy of the molecule, holds good. Question number 36. 1 Pascal is equal to how many dynes? A. 10 dynes per square centimeter, B. 1 dynes per square centimeter, C. 100 dynes per square centimeter, D. 0.1 dynes per square centimeter. The correct answer is option A, 1 Pascal is equal to 10 dynes per square centimeter. Question number 37. The electrode of a battery must be A. Semiconductor, B. Good conductor of electricity, C. Insulator, D. Bad conductor. The correct answer is option B, good conductor of electricity. Question number 38. The statement which is true for fuel cell is A. They make more pollution. B. They produce noise. C. They liberate more heat. D. They are heavy in weight. Here the correct answer is option C, because fuel cell is a galvanic cell which produces large amount of heat. Question number 39. Gas law, which gives the relation between pressure and volume changes, is A. Boyle's law, B. Gay-Lussac law, C. Charles' law, D. Hooke's law. Here the correct answer is option A. Boyle's law. Boyle's law is a law stating that pressure of a given mass of an ideal gas is inversely proportional to its volume at constant temperature. Question number 40. 100 degrees Celsius, when expressed in absolute scale, is A. 100 Kelvin, B. 273 Kelvin, C. 0 Kelvin, D. 373 Kelvin. The correct answer is option D. 373 Kelvin. Question number 41. The process of coating zinc over iron is known as A. Galvanizing, B. Tinning, C. Alloying, D. Non-metallic coating. The correct answer is option A. Galvanizing, because galvanizing is a process of applying a protective layer of zinc coating to iron or steel to prevent rusting. Question number 42. SOFC is a type of A. Primary cell, B. Secondary cell, C. Fuel cell, D. Solar cell. SOFC is also known as solid oxide fuel cell. Therefore, the correct answer is option C. Fuel cell. So, SOFC is a type of fuel cell. Question number 43. Magnesium is an alloy made by combination of aluminium and A. Magnesium, B. Phosphorus, C. Zinc, D. Tin. So, magnesium is an alloy made by combination of aluminium and magnesium. So, the correct answer is option A. Magnesium. So, magnesium is an aluminium alloy with 5% magnesium and 95% aluminium. Question number 44. Zinc carbon battery is an example for A. Secondary battery, B. Primary battery, C. Fuel cell, D. Solar cell. The correct answer is option B. Primary battery, because in it a zinc casing act as anode surrounding a carbon rod which act as cathode. Between them electrolyte is pasted which works as the battery. Question number 45. Which of the following is not a polymer? A. Teflon, B. Nylon, C. Bakelite, D. Glass. The correct answer is option D. Glass, because glass is made from natural and abundant raw material like silica, soda ash and limestone that are melted at a very high temperature to form a glass. So the correct answer is option D. Glass. Question number 46. pH value of distilled water is A. 13, B. 7, C. 2, D. 11. The correct answer is option B. 7, because the normal distilled water has a pH of less than 7 and is acidic because it dissolves some amount of carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. Question number 47. Who had invented pH scale? A. S.P.L. Sorensen, B. Benjamin Franklin, C. Henry Moseley, D. Wilhelm Rontgen. The correct answer is option A. S.P.L. Sorensen. The concept of pH was introduced by Danish chemist by S.P.L. Sorensen at Carlsberg Laboratory in 1909 and revised to modern pH in 1924 to accommodate the definition and measurement in terms of electrochemical cell. So the correct answer is option A, S.P.L. Sorensen. Question number 48. A polymer is any substance made up of many repeating units called A. Resins, B. Murs, C. Blocks, D. Plastics. The correct answer is option B, Murs, because a polymer is any substance made up of many repeating units and building blocks called Murs. Question number 49. The postulates of Arrhenius' theory are A. When electrolyte is dissolved in water molecules split into ions. B. Positively charged ions, negatively charged ions. C. For a given solution is electrically neutral. D. All the above. The correct answer is option D, all the above. Question number 50. The current flow through electrolyte is due to the movement of A. Ions, B. Holes, C. Electrons, D. None. The correct answer is option A, ions. Since the current flows through the solution in the form of positive ions, that is cations, moving towards the negative electrode, and negative ions, anions, moving towards the positive electrode. Therefore, the correct answer is option A, ions.
Thank you all for your cooperation. For further details, you can contact Dr. Damodar N., HOD of Department of Chemistry. Thank you once again.